you like to hear the story of how I messed up my life?
No!
Me too. Let's look at some graphs first.
Study drugs aren't commonly known, but they are commonly used. Students use them to help them focus before an upcoming test. As you can see, marijuana is the most commonly used study drug, but there are many more. According to this poll, Ritalin is the least commonly used study drug. It doesn't matter what the drug is, they are all bad.
Oh, hey, man.
Hey, man.
I've been meaning to tell you. I've been using this thing. It's called a...
In this graph, it shows you the percentage of people doing Adderall, a common study drug. The red bars represent college students, and the blue bars represent other people who are 18 to 22 years old. The graph is split up into five columns. Persons 18 to 22, 18 to 20, 21 or 22, and then male and female. Obviously, study drugs are more common in college students than others. People who are 21 to 22 in college use them the most. To be exact, 7% of all college students who are 21 and 22 use study drugs. Bobby eventually got caught using study drugs. Next, you will see what his guidance counselor and his father have to say about this.
Sir, are you aware that your son is on study drugs?
No, sir, I am not.
We'll bring him up to the office right now. We're going to have to try to talk to him. Is that your son?
Yes, that is little Bobby.
Yeah, this is going to be a long talk. So, I guess we have a couple of different ways we can fix this. One, we can send him to an institution.
No, that would be way too much money. Are you kidding me? I can't talk to him.
Ben, what do you mean?
Yeah.
He's your son.
I know that.
You need to talk to him. Like, just
Bobby, damn.
What?
I can't talk to him.
Yeah, I'm just going to good luck.
No, but you can't do that.
With that.
Stop putting these drugs.
After 5 days.
Later.
I swear that was me.
See this sweet, innocent little kid? He's only just a little kid, but in a few years, he'll be experiencing all this stuff with the drugs. You wouldn't want him getting into drugs and all this, because, you know, he might think it'll help him, but truly, it won't. You can do your part to help. If you see anybody, even if it's your friend, doing drugs, you need to report it to somebody, because it could help them more than it would hurt them.
Study drugs aren't always a bad thing, though. In Chain Victorino's case, he has a medical diagnosis of ADD, attention deficit disorder. In other words, he can't focus on things as well as you and me. His doctor told him to take Ritalin, a common study drug that high school and college students are using now. This is a totally different story than what they are doing. They are just abusing them and using them not the way they were made, while Victorino has a good reason to be doing this. Without Ritalin, Victorino wouldn't be as good as a baseball player is today. But with high schoolers, they aren't using it the way they were made.
Thank you for watching our film.